In this video, I will show you how to navigate back to the main menu screen after the camera zoom cutscene has played. If you haven't watched part 1 of this tutorial, you can find a link to it in the description. First, you will need to create a new widget if you haven't already. For this tutorial, I have made a new menu widget for the new game screen, which includes a button that will take me back to the main menu. I will be using this as a 3D widget later for my game, but the overall method shown in this video will work for regular widgets as well. Continuing from last time, let us open our game mode and find the zoom in function we already created. We will be modifying our code slightly so that we can play our cutscene in reverse. First, add a Boolean variable called isZoomed and set the default value to false. Create a branch after create level sequence player, using our new variable as the condition. If isZoomed is false, we will play our sequence as usual, and set isZoomed to true after that. If your widget will exist in the world as a 3D widget, ignore this event dispatcher for now and we will revisit it toward the end of this tutorial, otherwise you can ignore it completely. Now if our branch is true, we will use play reverse and set isZoomed to false. Now hit compile and save, and let's head back to our new widget. For this tutorial, make sure you've already created some type of back button. Highlight your button, and scroll down the details list until you see unclicked. Select it, and the graph should open up. Like the previous video, we will simply be casting to the game mode, and calling our zoom in function. This will bring our camera back to the main area. We also want our main menu to reappear on the screen, so we will create our main menu widget, and add it to the viewport. For style, I've created a fade animation. If you want to learn how to create stylized menu screens, you can check out the description for a tutorial on that. Hit compile and save. If you're switching between two menus and you are not using 3D widgets, then you should remove from parent after you're finished with your widget so that it will remove itself from the screen. Open your level blueprint, and let's make sure that we are able to see our cursor. You may have a different cursor setup, or your own keyboard navigation for this, and that's fine too. That should be all you need to be able to zoom back and forth and navigate between these two menus, however. If you are using 3D widgets like I am, then your next step is to create a blueprint class actor. In my case, I'm creating a computer monitor screen using the widget I've made. To do this, I added a static mesh, and assigned my monitor model and materials to it. Now to create the 3D widget, click Add Component then Widget. As a tip, to improve the resolution a bit, make the draw size large, and just scale down your widget after, using Transform. Make sure your widget custom width and height match your draw size. Now assign the widget you've created to the widget class under User Interface. In the Details window, scroll down until you see Receive Hardware Input under Interaction. Make sure this is selected. Save all your changes and let's go back to our game mode and add some event dispatchers to our zoom in function, which will handle whether or not the player can interact with our new menu. Add two event dispatchers, one for enabling our widget, and one for disabling our widget. Drag and drop those into our blueprint and select call. After play reverse, call the disable event dispatcher. After play, call the enable event dispatcher. Compile and save. Going back to our 3D widget now, select the event graph. By default, we don't want the player to be able to interact with this menu just yet, so we will set actor enable collision to false on event begin play. Next, cast to your game mode, and we will bind our event dispatchers to custom events. What this does is that when our zoom in function is called, say for example we zoomed into the monitor into our new game screen, our event dispatcher will tell our 3D widget, hey, we are currently zoomed in, so please fire the event that will enable interaction with our widget. Otherwise, when we are zoomed out, we should disable that widget so the player can't click on those widget buttons. To create a custom event, right-click anywhere and type custom, and add custom event should show up. Create one event to enable interactions, and one event to disable. Then, we need to bind our event dispatchers accordingly so that they can listen and wait for our signal to fire the custom event. The delay here is optional, I included it to add a bit of delay to wait for my stylized animations to finish up. Compile and save. We're nearly done. I just want to add one last thing in our main menu graph. On the button click, I want to make sure that while my stylized animations are fading my menu away, I want to disable the main menu so that the player can't spam the fading options after they've made a choice. Once a button is chosen from the main menu, I don't want them to be able to click anything else until they see the new menu. To do that, I simply added set is enabled and set it to false. Now all that's left is to drag and drop our new 3D widget into the world. I placed mine where the camera will be zooming into. And we're done. Thanks for watching, I hope this helped. If you have any suggestions to improve upon this method, let me know in the comments.